Hi, I'm Philia Steyn and I'm the safari expert, and I'm currently walking on a game trail that leads to a small natural pool of water here in the Hoedspruit Wildlife Estate. Now, it's along this very game trail that I had my camera trap set up for episode 1 in my camera trapping series. And that water hole has since dried up, filled up again, and then dried up once again. But then over the weekend, very unexpectedly, we had 50 millimeters of rain, and now it's filled up again. I enjoyed seeing animals coming down to drink at Hammerkop Dam in episode 5 so much that I decided, let's put the camera trap up on this little waterhole and see what comes down to drink until it dries up. Now, for those of you that don't know, I actually started a Patreon page, and that's an opportunity for you to show support for the channel through a small donation. And if you become a patron, you'll also get a chance to vote where I put the camera trap next in episode 7. So if you'd like to do that, go and check out the link at the top of the video description. I just looked down, and guess what came to drink during the night? A big male leopard. Right, let's put up the camera trap. Right, so the camera trap is up, and the reason that I chose this angle specifically is that it seems to get very nice morning light, and I'm pretty sure in the afternoon it'll get good light as well. Unfortunately, I can't cover both edges, so I kind of had to decide where I think the most animal traffic would be, and by the look of the tracks, I think it's this side, and I think it's because that game trail leads straight here. So let's hope I made the right decision. Let's hope the animals don't knock it over or mud bath against the camera. At some stage, you might see the camera angle change just a little bit, and that's because I have to move it when the water starts drying up. Enjoy.
Yeah, it looks like the water shifted a little bit too far, so I'm going to move it over a little bit this way. Look a little bit skew. I think I'm going to move the camera completely to face the other side of the waterhole.
Thanks to all my diehard fans that watch right to the end of the video. You guys are the true nature lovers. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and feel free to ask any questions you might have in the comments down below. Now, as you can see, all of the drinking water has dried up at this natural pan. There's a little bit of mud left, but I think it's time to move the camera trap. And this week, I'm going to give my patrons the chance to vote where they want me to put it up next. So option number one is to take it to the fence line again to see which animals come in and out of the wildlife estate through one of the holes in the fence line. The second option is to find a nice game trail like I had in episode one of this series, perhaps somewhere in a thicket, just to see which animals walk up and down that game trail. The third option is to take it back to the marking tree not far from here, where we had that amazing sighting of the leopard jumping into a tree. Maybe use a different angle and see what we can get there. And then the fourth option is to take the camera trap to my garden, where I would put it overlooking my bird bath so we can see which bird species come down to drink. So if you're not familiar with my Patreon page, go and follow the link at the top of the video description. It's basically an opportunity for you to support the channel if you like it through a small donation. And in return, you'll get small rewards like early access to my videos, behind the scenes footage, and like I just mentioned, the option to vote which video I post next. Thanks so much again for watching, and I'll see you next time.